I don't think I would be afraid at all. I'd be pretty accepting of the situation. I've had a pretty good life. I've lived and travelled and drank and ate, and I think I'd be ready. I'd be ready.
I'd definitely take my children out of school if I had a final 30 days and make the most of that time for them, because the loss would be left with them, and I'd want them to look back and remember me not as the mum that told them to make their bed and pick up their clothes off the floor every day, but the mum that was fun-loving and took them to see some amazing things.
Ideally, I'd like to be somewhere that I'm used to. I'd like my family around me, and I'd like my dog as well. But I do acknowledge that that's not always possible, depending on what particular types of care I might need or the burden on the family. But ideally, I'd like to be at home.
I certainly have had a conversation about my end-of-life wishes with my family. When I was about 15 years old, I had three friends die in a car accident, and that was obviously quite unexpected, and it was very hard to come to terms with. And as I got older, that theme seemed to continue. So I've actually now had seven friends who have died as a result of car accidents. A majority of those people also donated their organs. So for me, it was really important that my family knew, if that ever happened to me, that they knew that I wanted my organs donated.
So often, lack of clarity about people's goals and intentions towards the end of life result in stress and conflict for the family. I know from my own clinical practice that on those occasions where people had gone to the trouble of writing out a plan, it was enormously helpful, because we could sit down with the family, read the plan, and everybody could agree to accede to that person's wishes.
As a nurse, I would always sit and talk to the patients, especially after the doctor had been in, because often they don't understand completely, or they actually don't hear. But I think people know their bodies, and the body talks to them, and they know something's happening and they're probably dying. And so you'd go in and you'd actually talk through with the patient of what they've heard and explain it in layman's language, really, to them what it means, and support them to discuss it with their family.